set the context of the problem here, Sridhar. How difficult is it to get access to all data out there at the moment to make generative AI become this reality?
Well, great to be here, Caroline. AI has a lot of promise for making data very broadly available to everyone in the enterprise, including business users, using natural language, which all of us like doing. But the problem often is that the meaning behind the data is in multiple places. It can be in databases, it can be in business intelligence tools. This just makes developing AI solutions on top of this data very hard. And what we announced today with a consortium of industry folks is an open standard for exchanging this semantic information. And what that means is this is going to enhance interoperability between different folks, between Salesforce, DBT Labs, BlackRock, we would like to see happen. It can help accelerate value that is going to be gotten from AI. It also just simplifies things for everybody that's involved. And that's why we're super excited about working with these giant industry players to announce this new interchange format.
Yeah, a universal translator is kind of a nice way of talking about it with Snowflake, the Salesforce, DBT Labs, BlackRock, ThoughtSpot. Wiggy here on this program, can you tell us about how difficult the technology exchange is going to be here, what actually you need to do beneath the surface?
Yeah, it's a standard. What this means is that people that want to be part of the standard or want to conform to the standard just are going to make it easy to send and receive this semantic information. This is, you know, this is business stuff, stuff like how is revenue defined, how is profit defined, how is EBITDA defined, and so on. So we intentionally wanted it to be a light lift for each of these players. But what happens collectively is that all of a sudden, the semantic information is free to move about. It just makes value creation, especially with AI, just a whole lot faster. And it's a big step forward for the industry. And we expect more and more folks in the data industry to be a part of this standard.
Interesting. So that's for the data industry. Going to the large language model industry in and of itself, Anthropic seemed to have seen this issue with data and interoperability as well. They've been seeing silos. They introduced something called Model Context Protocol. That's, again, standard. Sridhar, how is that different?
Well, this is one layer below that. What a Model Context Protocol does is it creates a standard way, for example, to talk to an AI agent. But on the other hand, even to create the AI agent, you need to make sense of the underlying data. It can be the case that you have data sitting in one place while the definition for what the data means is in a different place. This makes it easier to create agents, which can then take advantage of protocols like Model Control Protocol, MCP, that you mentioned, to make agent interoperability work a whole lot better. So you need all of these layers for AI value to get created.
And we need the agents to get better, for the productivity to really result. Sridhar, I ask you, like, after months of worry, perhaps about MIT reports saying that ultimately the productivity gains aren't being seen yet, what are you seeing with your clients using your own offerings and products?
Yeah, we are seeing a lot of productivity gain in specific areas. And I can speak even personally to examples like my sales data is just a whole lot easier for me to get to with Snowflake Intelligence. BlackRock, one of the customers in the OSI standard, also is using our AI products to create what's called a customer 360. So when you call BlackRock, the person on the other side has access to all of the relevant information about you. It's things like that that are creating value. And what's unique about Snowflake is we let our customers create AI products without a ton of investment on their part. We make it much easier to iterate and create these products and use them and see for themselves what's creating value before turning on the spigot and having these products exposed more and more. And in areas like coding agents, the productivity gains that we are seeing is truly remarkable. And I think that's an area where you will continue to see a ton of adoption across the board in enterprises. Funnily or strangely, it turns out that coding is one of the most interesting and important applications of language models.
Sridhar, we've seen the adoption of your products. It's shown up in your earnings. People have seen really the growth that you're talking about. For that, you need sales and marketing people to go out and sell your products. But that's where your talent addition has been. But I go to the news of the day, for example, around H-1B visas. How much is that becoming an issue for you with talent? Is that something that you're worried about, access to the right people here in the United States?
Yeah, it is. It is an issue. Roughly less than 10% of our workforce is on H-1B visas. You know, I'm an immigrant, and I think there are a ton of folks like me that come in, create massive amounts of value, and then become proud citizens. We don't see it as an immediate problem, but we do think that tech workers from around the world have a lot to add to the tech industry. We are watching and working as closely with the administration as we can to make sure that this is more of a win-win for everybody involved.